शिवेश कुमार महोदय आह्वान करोमि प्रथम प्रस्तावनं करोति इति आह्वानं करोमि। शशिकांत महोदय
नमस्कारम 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 टू ऑल ऑफ यू। आई एम डॉक्टर टीपीएस फ्रॉम हैदराबाद। इट्स ऑलमोस्ट 2-3 वीक्स आई गॉट इंट्रोड्यूस्ड टू प्रभाकर जी एंड वेद संस्कृति समिति। सब्सिक्वेंटली दिस इज सेकंड और थर्ड meeting and sessions which we are into, where we are deeply thinking about the activities which can be started, wherein we believe that the new education policy has triggered, initiated, wanted the education system to be more stronger with a great base starting from age 3, where age 3, 4, 5, the so called nursery LKG UKG business, which is run by most of the institutions, are handled by probably not the best trained, professionally qualified, who understand the basis of education, who has been formed well, but maybe in the hands of few ayas, and the academy sector, like the formed education system, only takes care of children from grade 1 onwards. The new education policy principally emphasizes the requirement of taking the nursery LKG UKG grade 3 onwards into the formal education policy, and it emphatically mentions the primary education should be without a bundle of textbooks, not homework, and it has to be based on activity, craft based, which has got the Indian culture and Indian spirituality emphasized, so that from the root itself the children are grown up like with the value system and the wisdom which Vedic Indian system gives. But I have my own doubts, having spoken on national education policy at various length on different institutions. I found that most of the time the visions are not made into practice, because academia doesn't change that easily like technology changes or business changes. So there is all the chance that whole policy will get diluted in due course, unless somebody who is really interested takes it up and then start making the trigger, becoming the early birds. That is where we thought we have to intervene, creating good set of mentors with the help of parents and students, teachers, social activity people who are involved into spreading the Indian culture. That's how the concept of Grandma Gurukulam came into existence. Been into discussion at various levels, and few schools are going to start this, probably in the already running school as a special division, or maybe some few community based schools where somebody is starting. Today also there were two proposals to start in Hyderabad. So I'm sure by March beginning itself we are going to have few centers in place. So that is when we thought that we have to work together, and Veda Sanskriti Samiti also is taking it as a great step towards learning, because we have planned from age 3 to 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, where the maximum learning has to be with the Vedic culture. So to start with age 3 to age 4, we are only focusing on teaching students or engaging children. We don't use the word teaching, engaging children, where they will get into the dialogue and understanding in their mother tongue, plus few Sanskrit shlokas, verses, which can be taught by many people, depends on their resources available. So from then onwards, we will give emphasis to the life learning, logical reasoning, analytical skill, etc. And from then, by the time they become grade 8, the age 8 and grade 3, they will become equivalent to any students who are taught in any international school standards. That's what we plan. We have a very specific seminar on this same topic tomorrow morning. So I'm sure I should not take much of time. Thank you, Prabhakar ji, for looping me inside on this, and I'm sure I'm going to learn from today's discussions, and then at the end I'm getting another chance to round up to talk to all of you back again. So that time I will invest some more time. So pranams to each one of you for this opportunity and listening me patiently, and we will have more chance of interacting each other through the Veda Sanskriti Samiti. So looking forward for more and more inputs and suggestions and hand-holding from all of you, the elderly people who are gathered here today. Thank you.
Namaskaram, Mahodaya. Dhanyavadaha. Samyak arambham krutavan. Idanim Kripesi, what do you want to say?
Yeah, I want to tell... I'm Dr. TPS here. I want to tell, 2 days back there was a news item which just now I have forwarded to Prabhakar ji also. Ministry of Education revives Vedic education proposal. Earlier there was a proposal to have a board similar to CBSE for Vedic studies. It was turned down. In this is from the Economic Times. 2 days back there was a report which says that similar to CBSE, there is a great thought which is going to establish a board for Vedic studies by central government. And Bharatiya Shiksha Board, which will be run by Patanjali at Ramdev's Institute, and Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh is also planning to establish a center for education. Maharishi Sandeepani Rashtriya Vidyapeed is also going to have a Vedic institute which will impart this. So I'm sure this is the right time. There are a lot of people with the support of the central government going to establish. So it becomes easier. As Madhusudan ji said, it's not subject learning. There are a lot of content development which is going to happen. More should happen digitally today because digital runs faster. So this just I want to inform the August audience. Thank you.
We will go to the last session, that the last DPS to close the session with his concluding remarks on consolidating what have happened now. And then I will ask Dr. Babu to give word of thanks and the concluding remarks before going to Janakaramana and Pradhana Janakaramana. Yeah.
Namaskaram, Dr. Madhusudan ji, and it's nice that we had a lot of discussion, but always it becomes academic. When it comes to action, we have to be very specific. I was also part of UGC. I was academic staff college director. So 15 years back. So I know how does it happen in the university sector. I think when Rama has to fight war, he was never part of the kingdom. When Krishna has to fight, he was never part of ruling. So I think I'm sure always there is a scope for the people to work. And as you said, it's only 5 out of 160 who are at least learning Sanskrit for Udara Nimittam, to get marks and then get the avidya which is practiced, which Sanskrit was supposed to be for Savidya. I think everybody had same concern. So what we are planning to do is to educate. One of the consensus was to educate the children along with their parents. And also make these children to learn the competitive exams and all that in our center so that youth also will come part of it. So we are going to attack three generations, the generation to come and the present student generation and the early parents who may be below 40. I think if that can be done successfully as a model for few schools, which we are planning to start some few divisions in some schools with some influence, if that can work, I am sure we will become an early bird in the NEP. That's what we plan to do. That will become some flag for somebody to follow. Otherwise, as any policy in the government, once the government changes or it goes into the hands of academicians, it will get diluted. I keep saying government schools are only for teachers and administrators. Private schools are for parents, but we don't have schools for children. So we want to start something which is really cater the development in the all fivefold: physical, emotional, intellectual, social and spiritual. And that is what we aim to do. So tomorrow morning we have a session. I'm sure we are going to elaborate on what practically we are going to do on the ground with the help of Prabhakarji and the Veda Samskriti Samiti. I'm sure we are going to do some pioneering job. So thank you for your blessings and all the elderly speakers who gave their ideas. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Prabhakarji, for this opportunity.
We'll keep that link in the group. Please see that link and join tomorrow morning 10:30 session also. That is actual practical session, how to implement our ideas to the take to the parents and teachers and other people. That is a practical session that we are going to have. Let us see what happens tomorrow morning. Please join us tomorrow morning 10:30.